Watching us, it's always a joy to be coming into your homes. And I'm Dr. Tafsilim Soumi. I just want to say happy abundant year in Mount Zion Carnation Ministries. This year, 2018, we are saying this is the year of abundance. And I pray that you also partake in what we are partaking in by faith in the name of Jesus. So today, we are closing off the episodes that you've been watching in the month of January. And this month is February. We know that in South Africa, we are celebrating love. Some celebrate Valentine's Day. So we are going to be dedicating this month to love, to marriage, to relationships. Now, as we are closing off this episode about the Edenite, I did explain on the first episode that the Edenite are those people that are single but they are eager and they want to get married. So I just want to make this announcement. Unfortunately, I know that I did say that we are going to be having an event for Edenite in February, but due to unforeseen challenges, we had to change the date. The event is still coming, but we have to inform you about the date. So if you are interested on the topics that we've been talking about, I urge you to call the number that you see on the screen or write me an email and give me your details so that I'll be able to phone you or my office will phone you and give you the details about the event. So also I want you to write me messages, give me feedback of what you think, especially the single people and those people who were married and then are single right now. So I want you to give me feedback. So having said that, I know I'm closing off the topic today, and I just want to close with this. We will go to the Word of God and just read a little bit. I know that everyone, not everyone, but most people don't want to spend their lives alone. People want to be in relationships, but we can see that to be in relationship or to be married is not an easy thing. So you need, when you decide to get married, you need to have made a sober decision. So that is why it's important that as a single person, you invest on yourself. You do a lot of self-development. You build yourself up. You become secure so that when that time comes, you know that you are secure. You're not looking for another person to make you happy. You don't have so much expectation, but you can love yourself and then be able to give love freely. Because when you get married, life as a single person changes. You cannot be a single person, get married, and then expect to live like a single person. Everything, your concept altogether changes. You know, when you get married, you enter a new world. That is why when we find people who are cohabiting, they stay together. And then because there is no commitment, you find that there are no expectations. So you find that they will live for many years. But once they decide to get married, then all hell breaks loose. What causes that? It's because marriage is another world. It's a spiritual world. And Paul says in the Bible, it's a mystery. So it's something that we need to understand. So as I'm closing this chapter, we'll continue another time. As I'm closing this chapter, I just want to leave you with these words of wisdom. When we go to 1 Corinthians chapter 7, Paul talks in a broad spectrum about people who are married, people who are single, people who are divorced, people who are living a single life. But I want us to go and read verse 8, which says, "So I say to those who are not married and to the widows, it is better to stay unmarried, just as I am." It looks like Paul here was like observing many things that were going on in those times. And we do understand that the Bible, Paul wrote this long, long, long time ago, which means the problems that were there in terms that pertain to marriage, they still exist today. So it's not something that's starting today, the crisis that we see, they were already there. So he says, it's better for an unmarried person to remain single just as he is. But if they cannot control themselves, they should go ahead and marry. It is better to marry than to burn in lust. So that's what Paul is saying. Then we jump and go to verse 25, where he says, "Now regarding your question about the young women who are not married." I'm not sure why he spoke about the young women, but you can read the whole content of the scripture so that you understand the whole content. So it seems like there were questions that they were asked. As I believe that even at home right now, you have many questions. There's something that I've realized even in the church that we are leading with my husband, that single people, young people, they always, if you give them an opportunity to ask questions, they would like to dwell in this area about marriage, about finding a right partner. It seems like it's a burning question that is always in their hearts. So he continues and he says, "I do not have a command from the Lord for them, but the Lord in his mercy has given me wisdom that can be trusted." No, Paul has so much wisdom. "And I will share it with you because of the present crisis." You know, there were crises then, there are crises now. Even when we look at how people are growing up, you know, as human beings, we are impacted more and conditioned by how we are raised up, by what our parents have done, the environment, the things that are being said to us, even being impacted by the media, what is being played on television, which sometimes and most of the time is not a reality. We see things that are being played in movies and then we expect those things to be a reality, and you only find, no, it's not as easy as they portrayed it in the movies. So he says, "I think it is best to remain as you are. If you have a wife, do not seek to end the marriage." We are living in a time where many marriages are being ended because it's tough, it's difficult. And as we continue with this program, we will find out why it's difficult for people to stay in the marriage. And he says, "If you do not have a wife, do not seek to be married." But how many people seek marriage? How many people are longing to be loved? People cannot live alone. They want somebody to love them. And also he continues and he said, "But if you do not get married, it is not a sin. And if a young woman gets married, it's not a sin. However, those who get married at this time will have troubles." Now, when I'm reading that, it's not something good to hear, that if I get married, I will have trouble. But it's true. You see, next week we'll be talking more about marriage. And I can confess that when you get married, there are many troubles that you face in terms of yourself, like as we spoke before, in terms of like aligning yourself with your spouse. And it's a lot of work. So when you decide to get married, you must make sure that you are ready and you are willing to get to work. Remove all those glamorous clothes and get to work to make your marriage work. And then let's jump to verse 32. Paul says, "Yeah, I want you to be free from the concerns of life. An unmarried man can spend his time doing Lord's work and thinking how to please Him. But you know, even in churches right now, instead of looking and honoring God, people are so much in saying, I love that one. That one can be a perfect partner. You see, but I think we need to go back. I'm encouraging you as a single person. Let's enjoy your time. Enjoy your time as a single person. Honor God, serve God with all you have. Because when you get married, that privilege, you lose it. Because now you have to be concerned about your partner. So live in the present moment. Most people, they live in the past, worrying about what happened, of which they cannot change what happened in the past. They can change what's going to happen in the future. They can change what they do in the present moment. If they are not living in the past, they are living in the future. What if I will be happy when? I will be happy when I get married. I will be happy when I get the money. And they overlook the present moment. But the present moment is important. People, they live in their minds, they live in their thoughts, they are living they are living a life that does not exist, forgetting that they need to enjoy what is happening in the moment. So I'm encouraging you single people, rather than worrying about your partner, worrying about you are 30 now, you are 40 now, and you're still single, enjoy your life. Because when you get married, those memories, you have to cherish them. No, I'm married now, but I did enjoy my single life. Then verse 32, it says, but a married man has to think about his earthly responsibilities and how to please his wife. And that is true. There are so many things. So next week we'll be talking about the married life, enjoying love with Dr. Swanem Som. And I believe that you are missing him already. So let's go to the break, and then I'll come back and then close all this thing off. And I believe that you have been edified. In the name of Jesus, amen. Welcome back. Our program today is dedicated to single people. We've been talking about the topic that concerns the issues around being single, but yet you want to get married since the month of January. And today we are closing off the topic. And if you've been watching and following these episodes, you know that I've been talking to you about the event that it was supposed to be in this month, end of February. Unfortunately, we had to change the date because of some unforeseen challenges. The event is still coming, and if you are interested to be a part of the event, please call the numbers that are on the screen or email me and give and submit your details to my office. And of course, if you do have questions, you can use the same numbers or email, and then we will give you answers to your questions. Or else, if you have a feedback, we would love to hear what you have to say about the programs that we are running under Swan and Somi Ministries, the arena of the supernatural. So right now, as I'm closing off this program, I just have few questions that I've received from some of you concerning being single. I do understand that we are living in times, very challenging times, where everything is allowed. People have their own truth, but remember, as the children of God, the truth that you live by is the Word of God, and we have to agree with it, with what the Word of God says. So the first question that we have, it says, why is it important to get married? I think from the scriptures that we have read, people don't have to get married. Paul even says, for me, I would prefer that you stay single. But if your passions, you are out of control, you cannot control your passions, it's better that you get married. So you need to evaluate. If you can stay single for the rest of your life, that means no sex, no sex before marriage. And if you can stay single and honor God and serve God for the rest of your life, good for me. And it's even good for God, because you are avoiding a lot of crises, a lot of troubles, because the Bible says, if you get married, you shall surely encounter troubles. So if you don't want troubles in your life, don't get married. It's not, you don't have to. And then the second question, it says, how do you know the right person for you? We are living in times of change from what they were from olden days, where most of the time God will say, this is your wife. Sometimes people will be forced to get married to people that they didn't love, and then they will end up growing to love them. And right now we are living in times where people are free. So how do I know that the person is right for me? When you love that person. And also, for me, that is my personal view, it doesn't come from the Bible. I believe from my encounter, it's from me, that you should know a person. The person should have the values, complement the values that you have. Because your values, when they are violated, it becomes a problem. What does the person has the values like you? I've heard many young people, single people, especially women, they say, I don't want to get married to a Christian man because Christian men are boring. Men, Christian men, please, you need to wake up. Because you are running out of women. They are looking somewhere else. They say men are boring, but I don't believe that is true. It's a lie from the devil. So if you want to know which is the right person, first it must be love. You must have something that interests you in that person. But be warned, sometimes you do get attracted to the things that are the strength that you don't have from another person. Like, for instance, if I'm shy, I'll be attracted to a man who is masculine, who knows where he's going, who's decisive. And then when you get married, you'll find that those strengths, they become weaknesses, because you already have the man, so you're no longer interested. And when he controls you and when he becomes masculine, then it becomes frustrating to you. So you need to pay attention. That is why I always encourage single people, do homework. Spend more time observing how you behave, observing you, what makes you tick, what do you love, what are your values, what do you want from a man, what do you want from a woman. Spend spend time and be sure, and also make sure that you look at yourself while you are interacting with other people, because interaction is interaction. How you treat people is the very same way how you will treat your spouse, you see. So look at yourself. What are your weaknesses? What are the things that you don't like about yourself, and do something about it. Look yourself in the mirror and say, this one, I need to work on this, I need to work on this. Sometimes looking in the mirror and facing your weaknesses, sometimes people don't like to do that. They will rather blame other people, but I think it would work. Let me advise you, it will work for you. Just looking at yourself, look, are you a bolt, and what types of screw will fit in your life? And then, but even when you are married, when you think you are 12 size 12 bolt and 12 size screw, you'll find that there will be challenges. That is why I encourage you to work on yourself and be secure, and you are happy, and when you get married, you'll be able to work around all the challenges that are there in marriage, as Paul has declared. And maybe let's go to the last question, which say, how do you become one while you are coming from different backgrounds? It's like same thing. When we become one with Jesus Christ, we accept him and he lives in us, we become one with him. But in marriage, you become one by dying. So we have to die. When you don't die in marriage, like, you live to satisfy the other partner. You no longer live to satisfy yourself. You do this, you do that, you do this, you jump, and you expect the other person to say how high. You see, you have to satisfy love in relationship. For the relationship to survive, you give, you make the other person happy, and then hopefully the other person will do the same. So you die, and then in dying you become one. It's another subject altogether. We will discuss it more on the next program, when Dr. Swanee, my husband, whom I love so much, we'll be talking about love, marriage, celebrating love. And time is against me. Unfortunately, I cannot answer more questions. If you do have questions, please write to me. The information is on the screen. I have to go, but before I go, I would like to pray for you. I know that being single is challenging, and then when you come to marriage, it's even more challenging. So my advice to you, enjoy your single life. Be good, love yourself, fill yourself with love. Fill yourself with the presence of God. Allow God to fill you. Connect to the source, which is God, and then things will come right. It's not easy, but it's possible. So let me pray for you. Thank you to all the partners that are supporting us with prayers and financially. We just want to say thank you very much. So let me pray for you as we come to an end. Father, we are so grateful for the single people that are enjoying life in your presence. And even those, Father, that are struggling, we pray for them. We pray that you will give them wisdom. You give them wisdom to understand that they need to build themselves up. Firstly in you, and then build themselves up by getting all the wisdom and understanding that they need to get. I pray for you. May the Lord shine his face on you. May you prosper in all that you do, in Jesus' name. Viewers, we love you. See you next time. Same place. May the Lord bless you. In Jesus' name, amen.